Quickly going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure. Follows the process, as you'll see in a second. Very charming movie. Deserves to win the best film, if you ask me. So let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing a filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending as a state of perfection, which is a loss, becomes a state of imperfection, the loss phase, the limitations phase. Symbolism there is, for example, the Garden of Eden, which generally is lost. And the process of working your way around is undergone. You can start there or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events there tend to be referenced at later stages, as in this story. Most stories, such as this one, end with some form of state of perfection. If you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, psychological journey. You're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated that tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of X, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you are here, you're not able to return, so you have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, let go of the older limitations, etc., come all the way around until you're ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based around, and I go over that in great detail on the 2100 stage of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that. Let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So we're kicking off, in essence, in the imperfect phase, the loss phase. So we've got the opening dance sequence, and within the lyrics of that first song, we tell the story of an actress who, back at home, fell in love. It was a true love, but she had a dream, and she had to make the choice between her true love and that dream. And that, in essence, is a reflection of what we are about to see. And at the end, Seb tells Mia that when you have this opportunity, you've got to give it your all, and they choose to follow their dreams as opposed to stay with each other. And so one of the answers to that question is exactly what he says. When you have an opportunity like this, you've got to give it your all. So we come into it and we meet our two main characters. In essence, we go through a similar process meeting both of them until we get to our first threshold. So we've got our ordinary world, ordinary self, devolved state. So Mia, she, when we meet her, she's alone. In fact, they're both alone. She is going to auditions and not doing very well, so signaling really that she's not following her dream. She is a prodigy, child prodigy playwright. Following her dream would be writing her own stories, giving herself a part, not having to be a part of other people's stories. And part and parcel of why she's failing is at this stage she lacks self-belief. So we're going to arc all the way around to reverse out of that. So, for example, she's not going to be alone at the end. She's going to have a family. She's going to have a partner and a child. She's also going to arc around in terms of the relationship with Seb. She will be successful at that point. So she will be following her dream. And she will have gone through the process of discovering or rediscovering self-belief. She's also here a barista. She's working behind the counter serving movie stars. So she is going to go around and be the movie star. So go from being, in essence, invisible to being very visible and very successful. And she's also flat sharing with some girls here. And she's going to go all the way around to move in with Seb and then ultimately have a home of her own. So going round, arcing, reversing round in a number of ways. similar sort of thing. Oh, so then she's encouraged out of her apartment, which she's sharing with her with some other ladies. There's a quest to find someone, who can fill, in essence, the romantic gap, but also maybe, you know, a connection that's going to help you push along and actualize your dream. She resists that, but ultimately she's pulled out, and then she goes to the party. She leaves, and then she's pulled in, magnetically pulled in, towards Seb's music, and meets him, which in essence is him performing the supernatural aid function. In a romantic story, both partners are each other's supernatural aid in that they both encourage each other's change, they enable each other's change, they trigger in each other's change. And they tend to be magnetically attracted to that in your classic mythical stories. Same thing with Seb. In essence, he's in his apartment. He has his sister who he doesn't want to be there. She's an ordinary world attachment. Ordinary world attachments tend to keep you repressed as your ordinary self, tend to hold you back. While he is trying to move forward to follow his dream, she's holding him back. Classic interdictor function, saying that being broke is not sexy. She's discouraging his dream, in fact. So that forces him out. He then has to play tunes at this nightclub, restaurant, lounge, where you've got another interdictor figure who says, just stay, just play the list, don't deviate from that. And then when he deviates towards music that is, in essence, linked to him following his dream, he's reprimanded. That's what interdictors do, and then he's pushed out. He's fired. And there he also meets his supernatural aid, which is me. As I said, they are each other's supernatural aid. So then we go into the first threshold, and we are in a new season. This is where you meet your new world attachments. So they meet each other again. They're both stuck in this devolved state, so they both are, in essence, not really following their dreams. So Seb is playing backup, or he's playing to some unsuccessful band. He's not following his own dream. He's playing aha cover tunes, and we've got Mia, who's still a barista. She says, go get my car keys, and they go and find her car. And then there's a dance sequence there, and the lyrics of that sequence indicate that nothing is going to happen here. So there's a resistance to the first threshold separation. But the following morning, Mia has a smile on her face, so they overcome that, thinking about Seb. And Seb turns up at the coffee shop. And then they go for a walk. Films are being made in this world where dream comes true. And she says that she was a child prodigy playwright, or in essence, the belly of the whale. And this is where the deeper change that needs to occur is made explicit. So she says she was a child prodigy playwright, or indicates that. And he encourages her to have self-belief, write her own play, give herself roles, so she doesn't have to go begging and have to keep going to this failure. And then they go to the jazz bar, and he does says the same thing. He wants to open a jazz club, and she does the same thing, encouraging him to follow his dreams, have self-belief. And then physical separation, in essence, they agree to go on the date. Was it Rebel Without a Cause at the Rialto? So then we're going through a road of trials, in essence, phases. We've got Greg holding Mia back. She turns up. Greg turns up when she's supposed to go on a date. She has dinner with him, his brother, and his brother's girlfriend. And there she is alone in a crowded room, and she hears Seb's music, and that allows her to pull away from him. She's an ordinary world attachment, and let go of him, which represents who she was, and goes to running to the Data meets Seb, then they go to the observatory, there's the flying amongst the stars sequence, and then they kiss, and in essence, it's from there on, at the end of the road of trials, that they become a couple. And that's when you reverse around, and following that, you're basically on the other side. So that's when Mia begins to start writing her own plays. So she's beginning to follow her dream. It's a one-woman show, so she's indicating self-belief. And she's a couple now, and so she's reversed away from being alone. All the way around, Season of the Tangible Sword, where you basically find out who you are, and the gaps that existed there no longer exist here. Here we go to our underworld phases. That starts in the monster's cave here, where Keith turns up and offers Seb a job. Now, what happens in the underworld is that you're pulled back into the old way. You are forced to make the wrong choices, and you separate from your positive archetypes, the archetypes that are pushing you in the right direction. So Seb resists taking Keith's job offer, but ultimately takes it, and that causes the separation and the conflict between them, because Mia is following a dream, and Seb is not following his dream. He's just an invisible person in somebody else's band, in somebody else's dream. In essence, it's just a better paid position to his original position, where he's playing cover tunes. He's not following his dreams. He's separating from Mia. She sees him less. And then when he turns up for the surprise dinner and they have that argument, he demonstrates his lack of self-belief. All the way around to the atonement. So, in essence, from here on, what's going on is we are beginning to arc back down. We have Mia putting on the show. She loses her self-belief because she hears people being derogatory about her performance. She decides to leave LA, in other words, give up her dream, and she breaks up with Seb. So she's alone again, coming all the way around. And then we've got a classic rescue from without, refusal to return, crossing the return threshold. So she gets the call for the audition. Seb goes to get her. She refuses to come back, but ultimately she does. And again, it's about rediscovering your self-belief and rediscovering your dream. And then the choice is made at that stage where you let go of all of your limitations. Pretty much the same stage as, for example, in The Godfather, where the Don dies and Michael is free to do what he needs to do. There are no limitations holding him back. So that's where the choice is made, that you follow your dream, or you stay together. And as Seb says, as I mentioned earlier, when you get an opportunity like this, you've got to do all you can. So they go around, and then we meet them finally. It's satisfaction. They're successful. Mia's got a family. They're following their dreams. They've got self-belief. All of those things that didn't exist initially exist at the end. Seb also is successful, and we have also this flashback scene of what would have happened had they made the other choice. And I think they would have been happy making that other choice. And I think that references that not only one choice is the dream, but they, as Mia walks out, they look at each other, give each other a smile, and you know, they're happy, and they have made the right choice. So that's a basic breakdown of that story. Great movie. I actually hope it wins the Academy Award Best Film. The nominations have just come out today, and it's, you know, nominated for quite a few awards. If you want a detailed deconstruction of the story, you can order it off the website. But once again, I go over these movies just to show that all of these stories do follow this process of journey and change and transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which I go over in great detail in the 2100 stage of Journey Transformation, New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website.